With the tension push-ups, our goal is to try to create as much tension we can. So it's like I'm trying to do a super plank. I want to think about when I'm pulling myself down, I want to have my inner arm scrape up against my rib cage, and I want to have my elbow come to or slightly past my hip, and it's just like a row. So it's like I'm rowing myself down into my push-up position, and then I'm powering up. The whole time, I'm keeping like a super plank. I'm keeping my midsection super tight. I can jam my thumbs in, use my stomach muscles, push them out, and keep that tension while I'm doing the push-up. I want to think about with my glutes, if someone were to come up and kick me in the butt the way I would brace for that kick, I want to try to keep that brace the whole time. Now, just like with anything else, the tension push-ups are scale, right? So if you were like Bruce Lee, you could get it super tight. Every muscle is going to be activated. You're going to be using your quad, your legs. You're going to be using your back, your abs. You're going to feel like you're pressing through the floor with your hands and feet. That's if you're at one side of the spectrum. In the beginning, just try to keep that tension. One of the cool things about the tension push-ups is that it is a skill that you can transfer over to other movements. So at the surface level, it's just making the push-up harder. Instead of getting 20, 30, 50, whatever push-ups you're knocking out, you're probably gonna get 1 to 5. And hopefully they're gonna be really tough. Afterwards, you're gonna have to take a little bit of a break just because you're pressurizing, you're keeping everything tight. You're not holding your breath, but you're just keeping everything tight. You get the tightness and you're still able to breathe. Now, the cool thing about it is as you get better at this tension generation, it's going to be able to carry over or transfer over to other skills. So if your goal is to get a heavy bench press, people that bench press really well are going to be people that get tight. Obviously, you're going to be on a bench, get that brace, connect to the floor, connect with the barbell, pull it down, power it up. If you're doing an overhead press, same thing. You get the weight, you get tight, you're pressing through your feet to the floor, getting that connectingness, powering the weight overhead. It transfers over, not even to pressing, but getting that total body tension for squats and deadlifts. It's the sky's the limit. The better you are at that, the better you're gonna be at every lift. So is it necessary to get that tension to be able to do a push-up? Absolutely not. But it just depends on where you're at. If push-ups are tough, just get comfortable with them. Once they're easy, make sure the form's there. Once the form's there, really start working on that tension generation because it lets you do less reps and get more out of it. If you just come here and go 19, 20, versus if you hunker down, get tight, pull yourself down nicely, everything's tight. Sometimes it helps kind of get that connectedness with the hands and the floor. Sometimes it can help kind of wake up the feet a little bit. It's not a requirement, you don't have to do that. You control the volume. So say you start off and it's really tough and you can mainly just focus on your glutes or maybe just focusing on your abs, that's okay. As you get better at the skill, focus on tightening up. You can say your lats, your armpit muscles, whatever you want to think about. Right here, that when I pull here, I'm pulling myself down just like I would pull a low cable rope. Same idea. It's just practice. It's not the end all be all. If it feels weird or silly, you know, just keep practicing, work on your intensity scale. Maybe you start off at a 1 out of 10. As you practice, maybe you get closer to an 8 out of 10. Enjoy. Have fun.